point is made that the prophets were sent to every nation, not every generation.
Yes.
Now, the next generation who didn't have direct access to the prophet, they depend on their previous generation in the information that they received about the prophet. Mm-hmm. And therefore, in our time, we sit with the same issue, even in terms of Scholar Ahlul Bayt, that we depend on the information that has come. Along the way, starting from the people who get confused, etc. The subsequent generations are not necessarily then expected to believe like the ones with direct access to the prophet or direct access to the Imams. In the subsequent generation, it is a natural possibility that they don't have that ability to get to the details like the ones that mentioned.
Okay. In response to this comment, yes, indeed it is like that. And therefore, we means those ulama and scholars and thinkers who, I will say, have well established such opinion. They exactly believe that you cannot blame people for what they have not done. So if this generation is confused and lost due to the mistakes of earlier generations, they will not be responsible. But the question is this, that did they try to find truth or not? If they tried, in their given capacities and qualities and power and so on, they did try, still they could not come out, they will be rewarded for what they have done. They were not expected to have aqidah of Allah, for example. Me and you are not expected to have belief of Allah like Allah Muttabatabai had, for example. Even if you have somebody has a simple belief, there is Allah, Alhamdulillah, Rabbah, who created us, and he understands his government, which is government, that's fine. You don't have to have the Tarina in that detail and in that technicality, in that, for example, like the Lastrawallah. So, if people try, the issue is, goes back to the discussion about divine justice. I don't know if I record this discussion in his book also. There he says that what is the definition of Islam? What is the definition of Islam? Some people think that the definition of Islam is your name is Islamic. If you wear a kufiya and top and you know, wear something, that's a cultural Muslim. Muslim, according to Quran, is someone who has this spirit that if he or she came across to truth, will side, will not resist. Aslama means surrendered. So if you, my brother, came across to the truth, for your cultural, social, political, material, emotional, any reason, you will not resist, but you will surrender. You are Muslim. Therefore, Allah Ta'ala rahmatullahi used to say that a lot of these Western philosophers, he used to say they are Muslim. Sometimes he used to make Fatiha for them. He said, no. When we read their books and we read their understanding, it's clear that they reached the truth and they surrendered to the truth. They are Muslim. You understand what I'm saying? Now, why did not, for example, in our own society, when we look at conditions, when we look at the people in the rural areas, far away from Can we expect from them to understand Islam like someone who lives in Cape Town can understand? No. But the question is that when you become adult and Allah has given you aql, and you use that aql to look for that truth and search for what is right and what is wrong, and you try and you surrender to what you believe, and you are a Muslim, technically talking, not term wise maybe.
It's true. Subconscious Muslim. Subconscious.
Yes.
When I spent English under the topic of philosophy and theology, the difference.
Yes.
There was a word intercultural way. I didn't see how it fits in.
Where it was?
The difference between philosophy
and I'm going back to there. Yeah, here. Where it was?
Philosophy depends only on pure independent
intercultural. Oh, I'm sorry. It's my mistake. Okay. It's intellectual. I made a mistake. There's my mistake somehow. In fact, I probably write and it auto spell somehow did it. No, it's intellectual, not intellectual. Yes.
And it was the last argument about the whys.
Yes, wisdom.
Why? The last arguments. Mm-hmm. Those arguments look to me like they were specific questions, but demanding a general.
Yes. Yes, that is very true. Those specific questions, but we replied them in much more broader.
Very difficult, because it becomes very complicated. Because a person asks a specific question.
For example, what?
And then those two questions that were.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, there it is.
Why are majorities not guided? It seems to me like, especially with the last one, hypothesis and show scientific excellence.
Mm-hmm. I explained.
But I mean, the scientific subjective, the person is asking the question in a very subjective manner. This person is asking the question himself, for himself. So I mean, it's very subjective. Mm-hmm. It's very subjective. It's like the person asks a specific question that he needs to think about for himself, but very often it's like this trolling on the Facebook.
Yes.
Throw something out there, you know, and want someone to give a general response.
Definitely.
And battle to try to think now how can I satisfy everybody?
No, you can never satisfy everybody, but in principle, what we are trying to say, that we have to understand what is purpose and role of Wahy. Wahy, Anbiya and Prophets did not come to address fields which were left for human beings themselves to evolve. They came to guide a common path between all the different fields of research and thinking. Guidance of Prophet is needed for a layman in the street as much as it is needed for the greatest of the research scholar and scientist in NASA. Both of them equally need akhlaq, truth, honesty, integrity. There's no difference in need of this quality for a man in the street who is uneducated, did not go to school, and to one who is sitting at the highest level of scientific research. That common ground is the ground of prophets. Specific fields are not the field of the prophets. There, Allah has left human beings to evolve and develop and go further. But Allah has guided us in that place where all of us as human beings require guidance. Yes, Brother Salaam.
You see, only come to remind.
Yes.
So which means you say also we had a bridge with Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala before.
Yes.
So meaning
Quran says?
Yeah, whatever we do.
Huh?
We already assign or upon it long before we exist.
That long before we came in this world.
Yeah. So, which means, for example, like the first question there says, why majority is not guided? Which means whoever is not guided was not guided before.
No. He was guided before, but he forgot. Therefore, Quran says the biggest problem, you know, insan, the word insan, comes from nisyan. Nisyan means forgetfulness. We forgot. Not that we were not given guidance. All of us were equally guided. Now, how? That's a different discussion. Al-Nizam. That's a different discussion. That what planet? Quran says in Surah Yasin says, Didn't we make a pledge with you that you will not worship except Allah? No, so many places Quran remind them. Didn't you give a pledge? Didn't you make a sign? Didn't you make a covenant with Allah that you will not worship except Allah? Which covenant Allah is talking? That covenant is part of our nature.
Yeah, but that's why I say that is a contract we had with Allah when he was a ruh or nafs, I don't know.
Yes, no, that's a different discussion. Some people say yes, when you were before you came to this world, Allah created all the souls, right? One opinion is like that.
Which means here we only practice what we already agree upon.
That's right. That's correct.
Which means whoever misguided is already decided to be misguided.
Not decided. He has forgot, or he has lost, or he got confused. Isn't that a lot of time you teach your children? Do this, do this, do that. But in the practical life, they do something else. Does it mean you didn't teach them? You did teach them.
No.
But they don't do what you have taught them. They go completely on the other side. Does not mean you didn't teach them. You did teach them.
Well, I get that question a lot. Why the majority is not guided?
Yes, very common question.
Now, I ask the person, how do you mean guided? Guided like you. I mean, I don't know what you're saying. Because that question needs to be, the person who's asking the question expects, this is my suspicion. This could be wrong. Why is the majority not guided as I am, or as we do, as our little group?
Yes, but then this is also the question.
That's very subjective.
Then that's exactly, it's very subjective. Because then the question comes, why you can say you are guided and others are not guided?
Yeah,
now the people who are Christians, they say Jesus is the only solution, right?
Well, doesn't the issue of free will come to me?
Huh?
Doesn't the issue of free will also come to me?
Yes, of course, that's the answer we gave. Due to free will. This is the result of the free will. That majority has decided to go astray. What we can do? But that's what it is, the reality. That's what is happening in the world. Why are you asking why? There is no why for it, but that's a reality, that's an existing reality, the ground reality of this kind of world.
But Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says he guided whoever he wants.
Yeah.
Yes?
He misguided whoever he wants.
He wants, I just explained to you, that want is a irada, it's a will, but he does not force his will. He guides whoever he wants. He wants who to be guided? He wants everybody to be guided. Law sha'Allah la hadakum ajma'in. That discussion is there in the text already. If Allah wanted, Allah would have guided all of you. Means what? That force you all to be guided. But Allah does not want to force you. Allah wants you to be guided by your own free will. And unfortunately, this is the reality that the majority goes other way, in the opposite direction. But it does not become a proof or evidence for anything. Because majority is that side which it is right. No. Majority can go wrong. Majority is not always right. Inshallah, let's take a few minutes break and then we can come back.